In the headlines, Harper looking for consistency in Windy's batting. Ronaldo test positive, and Fury not waiting for Wilder. Good evening and welcome to the Major ZDK Sports Edition for Tuesday, October 13, 2020. I am your presenter, Terry Laraji, and now for the details. We begin tonight bowling off with cricket, an area of great concern for the West Indies test team as they prepare to take on New Zealand next month is the batting. Struggling earlier this year against England, the Caribbean boys can expect similar conditions in the South Pacific nation. However, due to the COVID-19 pandemic putting a halt to most of the international cricket calendar, the West Indies will basically tour with the same squad that lost to England in July. Looking forward, CWI Chief Selector Roger Harper explains that ideally what the selectors would like to see is more consistency in the regional four-day championship to put pressure on the batsmen already in the 11.
At the end of the day, you know, you pick the best players you have available. You try to pick the best players you have available. And, you know, we encourage them and we hope and we pray as well that they'll be able to produce their very best and hopefully on a consistent basis. But like I said, when we look at our first-class cricket from a batting perspective, we do not see our players dominating and not enough players dominating on a consistent basis to really push and challenge the guys in the team. I think this year we had some good performances and we had those guys in the reserve.
Harper referred to the batsmen at a test level building a formula for success.
We want to see our players, our test players, the players actually playing in the team when they come to regional cricket, making big runs, right? Like I said, developing the habit, building a culture of performance so that when they get back into the international arena, they have that confidence there of having made runs and it becomes second nature. They have a formula for making runs that they can go and lay it out and produce and have that confidence and not be fazed by any pressure or any situation.
The West Indies selection panel also faces an uphill task selecting the 14-man T20 international squad to face New Zealand next month, although in a different manner. The two-time World T20 champions have a pool of match winners capable of single-handedly winning games and are sought after the world over. However, with only 14 touring, it would seem as though some players may be left out of the side altogether. A lack of leadership qualities around the region is the primary reason CWI selectors are not looking at changing the captaincy of the West Indies senior men's test team at this time. Harper confirmed this on Trinidad Radio recently, saying what he has seen of other leaders in the regional four-day competition, they don't know when to attack and when to defend, the same criticism of current test captain Jason Holder.
Four-day championship. You know, I had the opportunity to see most of the captains on show, and I think that, you know, there are some decent captains out there, but there's also a lot of improvement that could be made. I think some of our captains need to know when to attack, when not to attack, and how to defend, and how to put pressure on the opposing batsmen and those sort of things. I think these are the areas that, you know, that we need to improve on.
Harper's view is that too many regional players don't have enough experience playing the four-day game.
But one of the things that is lacking, I think, from a West Indian team perspective, is that a number of our players in the West Indies team do not have the opportunity to play a lot of regional cricket and therefore do not have a lot of captaincy experience, right? So that is a challenge.
Roger Harper. Harper stated last week that Holder will captain the test side in New Zealand next month, adding that there is no one at the moment that his panel sees as doing the job better. Windies legend Sir Kirtley Ambrose expressed thoughts on one such player who he believes has good qualities as a captain, Guyana's Leon Johnson. Ambrose believes he was unfairly dealt with when dropped from the West Indies test side.
I think he was hard done because nobody really into the batting did anything out, you know, spectacular. Right. I think Craig Batwick got 101 in the games. But, and he scored a couple of 30s and thing and, you know, kind of looked okay. And then after the tour, he was dropped and that was it. To me, he was hard done because nobody really did anything per se. Other guys were there, continued playing. Maybe when he came back home and he had played more, who knows what would have happened. And so, you know, sometimes in what if in the region, we tend to drop some people real quickly and others fairly for a while and get a long, long run. Too much politics in West Indies cricket, and that has hampered us for a number of years, and we need to wipe out this politics and the cricket will get better.
Sir Kirtley Ambrose speaking on ZDK Sportsline Show. Johnson, apart from leading Guyana to 5 straight regional 4-day titles, has played 9 tests for the West Indies, scoring 403 runs, including 250s at an average of 25.18. Meanwhile, cricket icon Sir Garfield Sobers was the special guest as the Barbados Pride celebrated their capture of the Cricket West Indies 4-day first-class title. In a luncheon at Kensington Oval, Sir Garfield presented the Hedley Weeks trophy to Captain Craig Brathwaite as the Pride players and team officials were showered with praise. The Hedley Weeks trophy is named in honour of batting icons and pioneers George Hedley and Sir Everton Weeks. Barbados Pride were awarded the title after 8 rounds of matches because of the COVID-19 outbreak. They had accumulated 134.8 points and were well clear of their nearest rivals. In accepting the trophy, Brathwaite dedicated the triumph in memory of Sir Everton, who passed away earlier this year at age 95. Meantime, overseas players from 7 countries will feature in the upcoming Women's T20 Challenge, scheduled to be held in the UAE from November 4 to 9. However, Australian players will not be a part of the tournament as it clashes with the Women's Big Bash League that begins in Sydney on October 25. One of the big names included, however, is West Indies all-rounder Deandra Dotton, who will be turning out for the Trailblazers. Just like the 8 IPL franchises, the women's contingent will undergo a mandatory 6-day quarantine at the team hotel, during which tests will be carried out on days 1, 3 and 5. Each of the sides will take part in at least 4 training sessions before the start of the tournament, which will run alongside the IPL playoffs. And Chris Gayle has ovary stomach infection and should be available for Kings XI Punjab's next match that comes up on Thursday. Kings XI Punjab made the announcement on their website that will be sure to please their many fans and those of the universe boss. Today in the IPL, West Indies all-rounder Dwayne Bravo and England's Sam Curran starred with the ball as Chennai Super Kings saw off Sunrisers Hyderabad by 20 runs to reignite their hopes of making the IPL playoffs. Curran inflicted some early damage with 1 for 18 from 3 overs, while Bravo, 2 for 25, performed superbly at the death, the final over going for just 1 run. The Sunrisers came up short of their target of 168, despite Kane Williamson's half-century. Scores: Chennai Super Kings 167 for 6, Watson 42, Sharma 2 for 19. Sunrisers Hyderabad 147 for 8, Williamson 57, Bravo 2 for 25. Meanwhile, referring to Deputy Director of Sports in Antigua and Barbuda, Jawaki Jones, who believes it's the responsibility of the ministry through the schools to bring sport back to a higher level, former West Indies fast bowler Kenneth Benjamin says back in the day, playing all disciplines during the summer holidays in the community made school sports vibrant.
During the summer, we would play cricket, basketball, football, volleyball, everything at the community youth level. That is all we did summer holidays. And so the school competition was vibrant. Why does he think the school sport is so poor? Because there is no youth activities in the communities.
Kenneth Benjamin. The debate continues as to whose responsibility it is in developing the youth with an eye on the future, community or school. In other sporting developments tonight, kicking into football, some English Football League EFL clubs will disappear within 5 to 6 weeks unless they get financial support, says Nigel Travis, chairman of League Two. He also said Project Big Picture, a plan by Liverpool and Manchester United to reform the English football pyramid, was a great proposal. The idea includes reducing the Premier League to 18 clubs and scrapping the EFL Cup. In return, the EFL would get 25% of all future TV deals, plus a £250 million bailout. Meantime, Cristiano Ronaldo has tested positive for coronavirus and will miss Portugal's Nations League game against Sweden on Wednesday. The Juventus forward is doing well, without symptoms and in isolation, according to a statement from the Portugal national team. All other members of Fernando Santos' squad have returned negative tests and are therefore clear to be involved in the match against Sweden. Passing into netball, following another outstanding shooting performance against the Sunshine Coast Lightning on Sunday to earn her team a spot in the grand final, Jamaica's Janelle Fowler has once again topped the scoring charts in the Suncorp Super Netball League in Australia. The 31-year-old Fowler has scored more goals than any other player in the league by some way, having sunk 910 goals from a league-leading 967 attempts so far this season. It is the third consecutive season that the towering Jamaican shooter is dominating in the number of goals scored. She also had 66 offensive rebounds, second to fellow Jamaicans Romalda Aiken's 110. Aiken, who plays for the Queensland Firebirds, was some distance behind with 583 goals as Caribbean athletes asserted their dominance in this category. Trinidad and Tobago's Samantha Wallace of the dethroned champions, New South Wales Swifts, was third in the standings with 522 goals. Stepping in the boxing ring now, Tyson Fury claims his trilogy fight with Deontay Wilder is off because he has been wearied by the Americans' attempts to fix a date. A Wilder-Fury trilogy had been touted after the latter stripped the American of the WBC title in February's rematch at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas after a draw in the first fight in 2018. Wilder, 41-1-1, has the right to a third bout against British star Fury, 30-0-1, but although December 19 was suggested as a possible date, nothing has been finalized. There have been claims Wilder no longer has a contractual clause for the rematch, which would leave Fury free to face Anthony Joshua instead. But Wilder's co-manager, Shelley Finkel, told Sky Sports last week, "They are wrong. We will fight in December." Yet Fury himself claims to be frustrated by attempts from Wilder's camp push back the date for the bout. Meantime, Kubrat Pulev will fight champion Anthony Joshua in a world heavyweight title bout in London on December 12, the Bulgarian claims. Briton Joshua was originally scheduled to fight the 39-year-old Pulev on June 20, but it was postponed because of coronavirus. Pedaling into cycling, the Jumbo Visma and Mitchelton Scott teams have withdrawn from the Giro d'Italia after six positive results in the latest round of COVID-19 testing. General classification contender Steven Kruiswijk, who rides for Jumbo, tested positive, as did four staff members of the Australian Mitchelton Scott team. Out of 571 tests, Team Sunweb's Michael Matthews also tested positive. Mitchelton Scott's British rider Simon Yates, another pre-race favourite, tested positive before Stage 8. In Tuesday's 10th stage, three-time world road champion Peter Sagan won the undulating 177-kilometer run from Lisciano to Tortoreto on the Adriatic coast. Touching down in Gridiron in the NFL's Monday night game, the Saints defeated the Chargers 30-27 with a game-winning 36-yard field goal in overtime. And finally tonight on this day in history in 1987, Vivi Richards brutalized a Sri Lankan attack in a World Cup match in Karachi. He smoked 181 from only 125 balls, and his last 81 runs came off just 27 deliveries. West Indies made 360 for 4, the highest one-day international total at the time, and Sri Lanka didn't even bother trying to get them. Instead, they settled for a 191-run defeat with only 4 wickets down. And that story has brought us to the end of our sporting developments for tonight. Now to recap our top story. An area of great concern for the West Indies Test team as they prepare to take on New Zealand next month is the batting, with CWI Chief Selector Roger Harper looking for some sort of consistency. I have been your presenter, Terry Laragi. Thank you for listening. Watch the NDK Sports package, go to the YouTube channel of Terry Laragi, The Straight Bat, and subscribe. Rally, rally round the West Indies.